Welcome to a Scratch challenge for Snowflake Constructions. This video shows how you can draw a beautiful snowflake with Scratch. The link to the Scratch homepage is shown here and in the video description. If you want to use Scratch for the first time, you will have to register for a new account. In order to do so, you have to enter a username and password. It doesn't work in my case since I've done this already. You also have to enter your home country, email address and date of birth for statistical purposes. The information about the gender is voluntary and can be skipped. You will receive an email that confirms your registration. Then you are ready to log in with your chosen username and password. Next to your name, there is a folder symbol that leads to all of your projects. Here we start a new project. The algorithms for snowflakes are so-called turtle graphics. Therefore, the cat will be replaced by a turtle. That is not really necessary, the cat could do the same job. It is merely to remind you that you can find further information about the idea of turtle graphics in general, and the links for this and for the turtle image are also provided in the video description. Let's start with the snowflake. In the event list, we choose the event when the green flag is clicked. This block of program will always be executed when the green flag is clicked with the left mouse button. Next, the turtle is located on the left side of the screen, a little bit closer to the top. The screen is understood to be like a coordinate system. The center of the screen corresponds to the origin of the coordinate system. Moreover, the turtle is told to look to the right initially. The turtle can be equipped with the ability to draw when the extension of a pen is loaded. Initially, we erase everything, and then the pen is switched on by the instruction pen down. Interestingly, the snowflake can be drawn with one simple pattern that is repeated over and over again. This basic pattern is now painted by the turtle. In order to do so, the turtle moves 100 points to the right, makes a 60-degree turn, continues to move for further 100 points, turns 120 degrees into the opposite direction, continues to move 100 points more, makes a final turn to the right by 60 degrees and finishes with another move by 100 points. Once the drawing is finished, the pen is lifted up and this is a good place to save the first stage of the project. This pattern has to be drawn several times, therefore it is advisable to create a shortcut. To implement this idea, Scratch provides the possibility to create your own instruction blocks. We create a new block and call it pattern. Furthermore, we can add an additional parameter that controls the size of the pattern. The instructions for the turtle are moved to the pattern block and the length 100 is replaced everywhere with the variable size. Now this block can be used as one simple instruction command that can be repeated several times and with different sizes. Besides the click on the green flag, there are other possible events that can trigger actions for the turtle. You can find these events in the yellow event list. Here we use the keyboard key 1, 2 and 3 to draw the pattern in 3 different sizes. It is not difficult to construct a first version of the snowflake from this pattern. The turtle has to draw the pattern 3 times and in between it has to turn by 120 degrees. To fit it into the screen, the starting point of the turtle is slightly shifted to the top. This looks quite nice, doesn't it? In the next step, we want to make the snowflake look a bit more like a snowflake. In the basic pattern, the turtle draws 4 straight lines. What would happen if each of these lines was replaced by the same pattern with smaller size? To see this, the following changes are performed. A second block is created and labeled with pattern 2. All instructions of the first block are copied to the second block. In the first block, each of the move instructions is replaced with the instruction for the pattern 2, however with a size of 1/3 of the original size. This guarantees that the smaller pattern fits exactly into the previously drawn straight line. Now it's time for cleaning up and testing. For the keyboard key 2, the turtle draws the block pattern 2 with the size of 100 and we see the familiar pattern. For the key 1, however, the turtle is instructed to draw the updated block pattern. And now a more realistic snowflake pattern appears on the screen. It is straightforward how this procedure can be continued. A third block is created and called pattern 3. it receives the instructions from the block pattern 2. In the block pattern 2, every move instruction is replaced by the instruction pattern 3 with 1/3 of the length. What's going on now? Instead of the simple pattern, the turtle is now forced to do the smaller version pattern 2 instead of every straight line. In pattern 2, however, every line is again replaced by the even smaller version pattern 3. For illustrations, again the key 3 shows the original pattern created by the block 3 now. The key 2 shows the first iteration where each line is replaced with a pattern of 1/3 of the original size. And finally the key 1 shows the second iteration where even every smaller line is replaced by a pattern of 1/9 of the original size. Again, we quickly draw the full snowflake, repeating the pattern 3 times with a 120 degree turn in between. With a little bit of patience, one could create a block pattern 4, pattern 5 and so on. But it is possible to do as many refinements as needed without much further efforts. To do so, the block pattern is extended by one further parameter that controls how often a line is replaced by a smaller pattern. This parameter controls the level of refinement, so to speak. Instead of calling the block pattern 2, we now call the same block pattern again, with 1/3 of the size and with the parameter level reduced by 1. This idea that a part of the program calls itself again is called recursive programming. This would go on forever unless there is a way for an interruption. We manage this with the additional parameter. When this number is 0, we don't call the block again, but the turtle simply draws the pattern with the current size. This is achieved with the orange control instruction if then else. As long as the level is larger than 0, the block is called repeatedly with 1/3 of the size and with the parameter level reduced by 1. Otherwise, if the number is 0, which will happen eventually, the turtle will draw the pattern with the current size. We simply copy the instructions from pattern 3 for this. The block pattern 2 and pattern 3 are not needed anymore. Finally, we can add a slider to control the level of refinement. If you manage to program your own snowflake along the lines of this tutorial, you can also try a slide modification. What will happen if you use a different pattern? If you want to, you can try the pattern that is drawn with the following instructions. With these modifications and skillfully chosen turns in between, you can create snowflakes that look like this. Good luck! Leave your ideas and questions in the comments. I'll hope to see you again. Bye bye.